When Samsung announced its Galaxy S21 range, it's no surprise that much of the focus was on the top-flight model, the Galaxy S21 Ultra. But do you really have to choose that model to have a decent handset? And are there benefits that the entry-level S21 has which the Ultra misses? Actually, yes. In this Samsung Galaxy S21 review, we'll show there are more than enough compelling reasons to save a lot of money by choosing this one over its Ultra sibling. Read more on Samsung Galaxy S21. The phones in the S21 range have plenty of differences between them, and these include both objective upgrades, a better display or extra cameras, for instance, and personal taste. One person's overly huge phone is someone else's perfect fit. We've already reviewed the Samsung Galaxy S21 Ultra, so be sure to check out our full evaluation of one of 2021's hottest launches if you haven't already. If you're curious about how the Galaxy S21 measures up, read on for the key differences you'll want to consider. Fetching, refined design, strong performance, very keen price, lower display resolution, limited camera compared to the Ultra, no ultra wide band price, $800 cameras, 1.2 MP ultra wide, 1.2 MP wide, 6.4 MP telephoto, processor, Qualcomm SM8350 Snapdragon 888, 5 nanometers, display, 6.2-inch dynamic AMOLED 2X display, 120Hz, 1080x2400 pixels, 421 pixels per inch, storage, no SD slot, 128GB or 256GB internal, memory, 8GB, battery size, 4000 mAh, dimensions, 151.7x71.2x7.9mm, weight 169g. The Galaxy S21 is not likely to be too big for your hand, while the Ultra just might be, and that's not just down to the screen size. The S21 is 1mm slimmer from front to back. That may not sound like much, but you can feel the difference. Samsung has usefully designed these phones with curved edges for a comfier fit, a palpable design choice over the iPhone's smooth edges. Another thing to note in the design, the camera panel. This is one of the most distinctive features in the new phones, with the lenses sitting at top left of the phone's ray, and sloping off the edge. On the Ultra, the camera panel is very deep, much more so than on the S21. Now, much of that is down to physics. For a zoom lens, the focal length is longer, which simply requires a thicker panel, but even so, this is another comfort win for the S21. But there's one way the Ultra really wins out: the way it feels. The glass back on the Ultra is classy and tactile, with the Samsung logo perceptible to the touch. The S21 has a plastic back which feels good, just not as good. But please note, this is one of the things that makes the S21 so light in weight, which is a definite plus. The S21 Ultra looks great in its standard hues of Phantom Black and Phantom Silver. Not to mention that there are three colors exclusive to Samsung.com: Phantom Titanium, Phantom Navy and Phantom Brown. All elegant and cool looking. But how about, you know, something livelier? Turn to the S21.